Hey everybody, thanks for joining us today on the Sunday session with Astara. It is a special time of year. You know, earlier in the month was Easter, and tomorrow is the Wesak, and the Wesak is the strongest full moon of the year. It is happening at 10:31 Central Time, 8:31 Pacific Time. And at the peak of the full moon, every year, people celebrate the blessings of the Lord Buddha. And there's about an 8-minute window where there is a downpour of energy from the Lord Buddha, blessing humanity. And so the full moon prior to this was associated with the Christ. This one is the Buddha. And then the next one will be all the higher beings. I think they call it the Festival of Light. And so with that, we like to spend time preparing for the Wesak. It impacts people whether they are doing meditation or not, but if you do meditation during the period where there is the downpour, it is said that it is the equivalent to meditating for 6 weeks straight. So, you know, if you spend time in meditation, which we will be having a meditation tomorrow night during the Wesak, you can physicalize that energy and accelerate your growth very rapidly in a single session. So the energy starts happening even a day or two prior and for like a day or two after. And so this is a time to rapidly spiritualize. So with that, let's have you just close your eyes. Take a few long, slow, deep breaths. Silently affirm, I am surrounded by the white light of the Buddha. I am surrounded by the white light of the Christ. Only good shall come to me, only good shall go from me. I am surrounded by the white light of the Buddha. I am surrounded by the white light of the Christ. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go from me. Om Bhur Bhuva Swa Tat Savitur Perennium Bargo Devasha Dimahi Diyo Yuna Prachodayat. Om. I am surrounded by the white light of the Buddha. I am surrounded by the white light of the Christ. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go from me. If you have a prayer or a wish for healing, hold that prayer or wish for a healing in your heart. Om Bhurbhuvasva Tat Savitur Varinyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvasva Tat Savitur Varinyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona Prachodayat. Om. I am surrounded by the white light of the Buddha. I'm surrounded by the white light of the Christ. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go from me. I give thanks, I give thanks, I give thanks. Yehovah, Elohim. Just be still. It is said that in the time of the Wisak, the Lord Buddha comes down to give discourse on the teachings of Buddhism, or just the teachings in suffering for humanity. It is given every year in Wisak in a valley up in Tibet, Nepal area. And you know, you could say that this is done through an inner transmission or a transmission of energy. But one of the things that I'd like to do right now is talk about the Four Noble Truths. The Four Noble Truths in Buddhism are basically a way to diminish and eventually end their suffering. And if you look at the Four Noble Truths, it really boils down to four simple steps. One, to acknowledge that there is suffering in life. You know, sometimes we have difficulties and we don't acknowledge them, but even the idea that in life there is difficulties. And a lot of times these can be an evolutionary process, or they can magnify our suffering depending on how we handle it. Sometimes the idea that we really shouldn't have suffering in our life without making any effort is actually also a source of suffering. When you boil down the sources of suffering, you can boil it down to three root causes: not acknowledging the law of consequences, which is what we would call cause and effect or karma, not acknowledging that everything is subject to change. Now, life changes, things change, situations change. And then the third is not acknowledging the law of cycles. You know, things are good in your life and then things are not so good. The sun comes up, the sun goes down, right? The moon comes out. You know, sometimes we think in the time of difficulty that things are always difficult, yet it passes. Sometimes in the times when things are going well, we think they're always going to be well and there'll never be difficulty again. And then something happens. And so these three laws are usually the root causes of almost all human suffering. You know, not acknowledging these three laws. So in life, there is difficulty or there is some suffering. It doesn't mean that, you know, life is bad. It's just there's always going to be some difficulties in life. These usually help us pull something out of ourselves that's much greater than what we would be willing to do on our own. So these are not really bad things. They're just things. How we handle them is how things become either good or bad. You know, there's this old shamanic saying, when you're in a situation of change or making some sort of transition from one thing to the next, you see the things pulling at you. And if you're unwilling to make change, you just see basically things that are negative or demons pulling at you, you know, pecking at your body or your bones. But if you've made your peace with things, you've made your peace with these laws, you've made your peace with your life, they're really just angels setting you free, helping you move into the next segment of life or into your transition. So again, it's not really good or bad, it's just a thing. It depends on how we perceive it. The second noble truth is to look at these sources of suffering, these difficulties in our life, and assess them. What does this mean for us? How are we establishing value for these things? Are these good? Are these bad? You know, for myself, I could say everything that's made me happy and everything that's made me successful was not something that I planned. You know, I would have these plans, I would put them in motion, something would go wrong. And how I handled those situations kind of dictated whether that it was going to be something that made me happy or something that made me suffering or made me suffer. A lot of times, what I was willing to do in the beginning wasn't enough, but the situation made me pull something out of myself much greater than I was willing to do myself. And so because of that, these situations in a way kind of liberated me from myself. I was self-inhibiting. I was not seeing myself, my true nature. So to go through and assess, what does this situation really mean? Is it really bad? Is it just a transition into something else? Or is it an evolutionary process? So the second noble truth is about assessing what is happening, establishing value. The third aspect, or the third noble truth, is then starting to form a strategy. Based on these things that are happening, what shall I do about them? Is it something that I step away from, or can I go deep and pull something out of myself, make some sort of internal change, adjusting and adapting to the environment? You know, there's this old saying, the reasonable man looks at his environment and then evaluates the environment and then looks within and makes shifts and adjustments inside himself to adjust himself to the environment. The unreasonable man thinks about what he wants and then forces it on the environment. So what that is saying is a reasonable man, and the reason being the pursuit of liberation or the pursuit of heaven, is we have to be internally flexible. We have to be able to internally shift and change. We have to be able to internally adapt. When we expect the external environment to adjust to us, that is us not pursuing heaven, not pursuing liberation, just pursuing our lower drives. So when we look to the strategy should be an internal evolutionary process. The fourth noble truth is simply putting the strategy in action. What steps do I do to make this happen? In a way, it's the simplest of all the steps, or all the truths, but it is the hardest to put into action because it is simply about action. You know, I kind of think of it in the point of view from the Christian tradition, where they talk about sacrificial love. You know, I think in a way that's a little bit misleading, that only at times would there be sacrifice. We sacrifice all the time. We sacrifice for things we love. We sacrifice for things we don't love. We're constantly sacrificing even things we don't care about. Sometimes we sacrifice because we're just on autopilot. You know? Take a political discussion. How many times have we sacrificed the effects it has on our family, our friends, on friendships, on business, simply because we have a view? That's still a sacrifice. Everything you do in your life, there's a sacrifice. There is a price to pay. There is a price to pay to be asleep. There's a price to pay to be self-absorbed. There's a price to pay to be unreasonable. And there's a price to pay also to pursue the divine, to be spiritual, to do the right thing. There's a price to pay to care about the thoughts and feelings of the people around you, to provide for your family, to love your family. There's always a price to pay. So sometimes, in with this noble truth, to sit back and look, what are the prices I'm paying for my opinions, my attitudes, my actions? And what am I willing to pay? Am I willing to sacrifice to bring something good in my life? am I willing to sacrifice just to keep on autopilot? This is a very simple explanation of the Four Noble Truths. So close your eyes. And you can either reflect or just let the energy kind of soak in. Put your awareness on your heart. Visualize a beautiful rose. Continue to hold that rose in your heart. Move your awareness to the top of your head, the crown. Visualize the bud of a lotus underwater, deep within the mud. The mud of our everyday lives, the mud of our desires, the mud of our automatic thinking. The mud of the stories in our head. Begin to see the lotus rising up out of the mud, moving through the water, its surfaces, it begins to bloom. Visualize the lotus in full blossom. Just be still, be aware, just let go. I, oh. Gently wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. Thank you for joining us on this Sunday session. And if you're available, join us tomorrow night for the Wesak Festival. We'll be doing a preparatory meditation and then meditation for the Wesak. So you can sign up on the website at astara.org. It's a free event, so if you can, please join us. Until next time, thank you for joining us, and I'll see you sometime soon.